Invisible Suit presents George Burns and Gracie Allen with Tony Martin and Ken Niles and Henry King and his music.
We love it.
Just a minute, George and Gracie will be with us. Meanwhile, this is Ken Niles to tell you about the soup sensation of the year, my special favorite, Campbell's Chicken Soup. And you'll know what a sensation it has made, since it's been so greatly improved, when I tell you that women all across the country are buying three times as much of it as they did only a short while ago. Am I enthusiastic about Campbell's Chicken Soup? Ah, you bet I am. And I'll say this. You'll find that it lives up to everything I've ever said about it. It's delicious home-like flavor. It's slowly simmered broth that fairly glistens with golden chicken richness. The pieces of tender chicken meat in it and the snowy rice and delicate seasoning. It's a fact I've never known any person to be disappointed in Campbell's Chicken Soup, no matter how high they set their expectations. So set your expectations high. Ask your grocer tomorrow for the soup sensation of the year, Campbell's Chicken Soup. And out tonight, Gracie Allen, I'm afraid, is going to honor the city of New Orleans. So here they are, George and Gracie.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Well, Gracie, say how do.
How do, George?
Well, now say something to the boys.
Oh, what do you want me to say to them?
Well, why don't you say something you think the boys would like?
Something the boys would like?
Yeah.
Boys... Gene Harlow.
Oh, thanks, Gracie. Thank you. Now, I think you want to say hello to New Orleans.
Why?
Why? Ken Niles just told the people that you were going to say something about New Orleans.
Oh, don't listen to Ken Niles. That's just gossip. Mm. And gossip is nothing but idle rumors. And idle rumors are rumors that can't pay their room rent.
Gracie, are you talking about rumors or rumors?
Rumors are rumors.
Rumors.
Say, that reminds me. Why are they making such a fuss over Simone?
Simone?
Yeah.
Well, she has two names that sound exactly alike.
Oh, yeah. What about the three Gracies?
Say, Tony, I need a little help.
George, don't count on me tonight. I'm in the middle of a picture and talk about hard work. Do you know that from 9 o'clock this morning until 7 o'clock tonight, I've done nothing but kiss Alice Faye?
Well, that's... nice work, if you can get it.
I don't mean that kissing Alice Faye isn't swell, but it's just work for me during the day and it takes all the romance out of me for my date tonight.
Mm. And who have you got a date with tonight?
Alice Faye.
Alice Faye, retake, eh?
Well, I don't mind, Tony. If you've got a date with Alice Faye tonight, you just keep it.
Well.
Of course, I was going to ask you to take me home tonight, but... I don't expect you to break your date with Alice Faye, but I do want to tell you that our sponsor phoned me and he said, Gracie, if you're not happy with your new singer, just say the word and we'll get rid of him. That's all.
Well, That's all. Well, Tony, it looks like you're on a spot.
Well, Gracie, I haven't exactly got a date with Alice Faye.
Oh, well, now, Bob Beamy's promise to break up any date,
oh, yeah.
Tony.
Bob Beamy's promise.
You just keep your date with Alice Faye, especially tonight, while you still got a salary coming in.
Hmm. Gracie, when did the sponsor phone you?
Oh, you don't have to worry, George. He thinks you're swell.
Hmm. You're sure he's going to let me stay on the program?
Oh, sure. As a matter of fact, you can even go out with Alice Faye and nothing will happen.
Thanks. Gracie, I have an idea that maybe you like Tony
Martin. Oh. You think of the silliest thing, George.
Don't I?
Yes. Well, I was out with a very adorable man last night.
Is that so?
Hmm.
I suppose it's some relative?
No, not yet. It's Clark Gable.
Not yet? Clark Gable. Well, you were out with Clark Gable last night?
Well, it's better than staying home alone.
I think so.
Well, anyway, here's what happened. I was at a party minding my own business, and Clark Gable came over, and he said, are you Gracie Allen? And I said, yes. And he said, how about sitting on my lap, Gracie? And I figured he wasn't sitting on it, and I had to sit someplace.
So you sat down on his lap.
Yes, and then my mother hollered. She said, Gracie, get up, get up.
Did you get up?
Oh, yeah, I jumped up, and I had breakfast, and I said to my mother, why did you wake me up, Mama? You spoiled a beautiful dream, I told her.
You said that to your mother?
Yes.
Oh, you dreamt you were out with Clark Gable.
Sure.
Did you ever dream you went out with me?
No, I never have nightmares.
Well, that's a pretty thought.
Gracie, as long as you're dreaming, how about dreaming I'm taking you to the Brown Derby restaurant tonight?
Oh, thanks, Tony, but that place is too crowded.
Mm. You can't dream you're going to the Brown Derby restaurant because it's too crowded?
Oh, yeah. I had to stand up in bed 2 hours the other night waiting to get a table.
Well, you ought to make your reservations before you go to bed. Either that or go to bed earlier so that you could get there sooner.
Well, that's a good idea. Yeah. You know, once I dreamt I was invited to the White House to visit President Roosevelt, but I didn't go.
Why?
Well, I wasn't dressed properly for it.
I see. Well, you ought to go to some exclusive foyer in your dreams and get yourself a fur coat.
Oh, I saw a beautiful mink coat last night that I liked.
Was it a dream?
Oh, I'll say it was a dream, and only $2,500, too.
Mm. Well, when you go to sleep tonight, just dream that I bought it for you.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah.
You know, Daddy Dempsey got a pearl necklace for me the other night.
Is that so?
Yes, and then the dream cops came and arrested him.
I see. Took him away in a little dream wagon.
Yes. Oh, and that was about 6 months ago, and Daddy is still dreaming.
In bed, huh?
No, in jail.
In jail, that's your daddy.
Gracie, don't you ever dream about me?
Oh, sure, Henry. I dreamt about you last night.
You did?
Mm-hmm. I dreamt I was out dancing with you, but when I woke up, I discovered it was my little nephew pounding my feet with a hammer.
Mm. Thanks, Tony. Come on, Gracie.
Oh, please, oh, my love. What is my foolish heart? Lovely, never, never change. Keep that reckless charm. Won't you please arrange it for time?
Fox singing The Way You Look Tonight. Well, that was swell, Tony.
Well, I'm glad you liked it, George. Mm-hmm. Say, Gracie, we're honoring New Orleans tonight, remember? So far, you haven't said anything about it.
Well, Ken, if you think I haven't said anything about New Orleans so far, just wait till you hear this. Ready, boys?
Yeah.
Oh, good. Now, honest. A toast to that great, gigantic, colossal, tremendous, lovely, quaint little New Orleans. From Seattle. It's 2,000 miles from Los Angeles. It's 15 hours from Dallas. It's 16 days from Christmas. And when you hear the time, it will be 16 minutes to 9 o'clock.
Wait a minute. So that's from New Orleans?
Yes, it's too quiet.
Quiet.
Gracie. Did you know that New Orleans is one of the healthiest cities in the world?
Oh, not anymore, Tony. I understand people are dying there this year that never died before.
Yes, and people are dying in Boston and Seattle, too.
Yeah, and they aren't anywhere near New Orleans either.
You know, I know one thing.
Yeah, that's very funny, Judge.
Well, I haven't seen.
Oh, yes, you have.
Oh, Gracie, here's a telegram that just came for you.
Well, just listen to this. Gracie Allen, pardon my southern accent, but you're nuts. Signed, the mayor of New Orleans. Oh, isn't that cute, George? You hardly knows me either.
That's what you think. Ken, before the people of New Orleans smash their radios, will you say something sensible about the city?
Oh, I'm glad to. New Orleans, which is sometimes called the Crescent City, is the largest seaport in the Gulf of Mexico. I can see it now, surrounded by its fields of cotton.
Oh, yeah. Ken, you don't get cotton out of a field.
No?
You get it out of a little blue box with a red cross on it.
Yeah, but where does the cotton come from?
From a drugstore.
You have to raise cotton first.
Our drugstore raises cotton.
Your drugstore raises cotton?
Yes, yeah, just raise those little 10-cent packages to 20 cents.
Go ahead, Jane.
New Orleans has...
Wait a minute.
Oh, quiet, everybody. Tony is going to talk. Oh, what is it, Tony?
Well, my great-grandfather owned the first cotton gin in Louisiana.
But Gracie doesn't know what cotton gin is.
Well, my daddy probably does. He drinks anything.
I see. He drinks cotton gin, huh?
Well, sure. When you drink cotton gin, you get a white nose instead of a red nose.
Please, Ken.
And New Orleans has three fine universities, Loyola, New Orleans, and Tulane.
Tulane? Well, that's my very favorite saying. It's one of the
oldest. Tulane is your favorite saying?
Yes, you know that old saying, it's never too late, Tulane.
It's never too late, Tulane?
Mm-hmm.
Gracie, another telegram.
Well,
what a talk you've got this week.
Maybe
it's a telegram.
Oh, it is a telegram.
It's a telegram?
It's from the grocers of New Orleans. Oh, listen to this. Gracie Allen, when Major Bo's out of New Orleans, we grocers sold 40,000 cans of coffee. Stop. Tonight, with you honoring New Orleans, we grocers sold 80,000 cans of coffee. Well. Now, that ought to show Major Bo who's who on the radio.
Sound a bit like an owl. It isn't who's who on the radio. You mean who's through on the radio.
George, we're selling Campbell's chicken soup.
That's what you think.
Oh, I think that's the nicest flyer that's ever been sent to me. I wonder what it means.
It means they want us to play a little game where you jump into the Mississippi River and pretend you're swimming, and after you drown, I pretend I'm sorry.
Oh, now why doesn't Tony say things like that to me?
Say that, Tony. Go ahead, Ken.
Oh, thanks. New Orleans has some of the most historical buildings in America.
Well, that's what I hear, too, Ken. Now, I'd like to see those beautiful drapes in the Saratoga Street Jail.
Beautiful drapes in the Saratoga Street Jail?
Well, that's what it said in the guidebook for tourists. It said that the Saratoga Street Jail is noted for its hanging.
I suppose your daddy would feel right at home in that jail.
Oh, sure. He'd soon get onto the ropes.
Well, that certainly is moose to me.
I don't get it.
Ladies and gentlemen, Henry King and his orchestra will play Sweetheart, Let's Grow Old Together. Come on, Gracie.
Oh, now wait, Henry. George, I forgot the biggest moment in New Orleans history. I was born in New Orleans not so long ago.
I get it, yes. And how many times have I got to remind you that you were born in San Francisco?
Oh, please, George. For tonight's program, I'm getting $100 to say I was born in New Orleans.
And who's paying you the $100?
San Francisco.
Play Henry.
This advertisement for Campbell's Chicken Soup has never been written. It has never been spoken over the radio. It's what women are telling one another about it. And it's this spontaneous, enthusiastic word-of-mouth advertising that accounts for the amazing growth and popularity of this wonderful soup everywhere. Think of it. 3 cans of Campbell's Chicken Soup are being bought today for every one bought a short time ago. That's right, 3 times as much. And here's why. Delicious home flavors. Campbell's use all the good, tender meat of plump chicken. And every woman knows what that means, chicken soup. And don't I know, too. Every delightful spoonful has that deep-down chicken deliciousness that makes everybody want more. And I ought to know because good old-fashioned chicken soup has always been my special favorite. And that's the kind you get every time you ask for Campbell's chicken soup. Why not do that tomorrow? Well, I'm a little bit worried. Gracie is standing right here with some more honors for New Orleans.
Well, why worry, Ken? You know things aren't hardly ever as bad as they seem not to be.
Things aren't hardly ever as bad as they seem not to be?
Yes, Judge, and even if they weren't, it wouldn't be anything to worry about unless they were.
Well, that's as clear as the Mississippi mud.
Gracie, another telegram.
Oh, there it is. Who is it from?
Oh, Western Union Postal. Who else could it be from?
Read it.
Oh, listen to this, boys. We, the citizens of New Orleans, have been listening to your program honoring our city, and we can hardly wait to hear the finish so we can listen to Freddie Allen. Oh, isn't that nice of them, Judge? They even like Freddie Allen, too.
So does Portland Hopper.
Well, I don't blame her. He's sweet enough to kiss.
Who, Freddie Allen?
No, Tony Martin.
Look, Gracie, you don't ask a man for a hug and a kiss.
No?
Now, nice girls don't do that.
Oh.
Hug and a kiss. Even if you want a hug and a kiss, you've got to be simple. Sort of hint at it so that the audience doesn't understand it.
Oh, well, hint.
Yeah.
Tony.
Yes, Gracie.
Tony, if you're tired, you can rest your lips against mine.
Well, that's being subtle.
Listen, Gracie, don't think I'm temperamental. I'd really like to kiss you, but I'm just not in the mood for kissing anybody.
Stop it. We're supposed to be honoring New Orleans.
Oh, now, George, please, that isn't nice. You shouldn't be rude to Tony. Especially when this might be his last night on the program. Mm-hmm.
Last night?
Mm-hmm.
Let's see, Tony Martin just came to work on this program.
Well, you'd better get to work then.
Mm. Well, I always thought that whoever I kissed would be my business.
Well, then you better do what I ask you, Tony, if you expect to stay in business, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, I'm sort of catching on.
Gracie, why should Tony Martin kiss you?
Oh, that's right, George. Why should he kiss me? After all, who am I compared with Alice Faye?
Yes.
I don't amount to anything. I'm only an insignificant little girl who hires and fires the singers. That's all.
Oh, that's all, Tony. That's all.
Gracie, how about me? I'll kiss you.
Oh, thanks, Henry, but you better kiss George. He hires the orchestra leaders.
Look, Gracie, I don't like to hear you talk, but as long as you're going to talk, say something about New Orleans. I thought I'd remind you.
Oh, all right. Remind me sometime.
I'll remind you now. How about a guest of honor?
Oh, thanks, Judge, but I just wait.
Oh, I don't know.
Say, I've got an idea. Maybe there's somebody in the audience from New Orleans.
Oh, yeah, maybe there's somebody in the audience from New Orleans. That's a great idea. Ken, why do I have to think of everything?
Quiet. Thanks, Ken. Ladies and gentlemen, if there's anybody in the audience from New Orleans that would like to come up on the platform as our guest, we'd be delighted.
Well, I'm from New Orleans, mister.
Oh, George, step and fetch it.
Step and fetch it. Would you mind stepping up to the microphone, please?
So, no.
So, you're from New Orleans, then?
Yes, sir. I was born and raised in New Orleans, and my mother and father were born there before me.
Well, if they're your mother and father, they'd have to be born before you.
Will you tell us something about New Orleans? What street were you born on?
Tropicula Street.
What street?
Tropicula.
Stop asking.
Gracie, a Chapatoulas is a very famous thoroughfare.
Oh, it sounds very romantic. If I ever go to New Orleans, I'd like to rent a little rose-covered cottage on how do you say that?
Chapatoulas. T-C-H-O-U-P-O-T.
T-C-H-O-U-P. Oh, no. H-O-P-A-double-T.
No. A-S-H-O-P.
No, wait a minute.
T-A-H-O-U-P-O-T.
Miss, why don't you move over on Canal Street?
I think so, too.
I don't know your name, miss, but I'm glad you stepped up here this evening. You know, I've always wanted to meet a real Southern belle.
Oh, mister. Tony, why don't you give the bell a ring sometime?
Never mind. Miss, what is the population of New Orleans?
Well, I don't know exactly. Being a river and seaport city, New Orleans has a great floating population.
A floating population?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'll bet a lot of them can swim on their stomachs, too.
I wouldn't be a bit surprised.
New Orleans makes a lot of friends with its hospitality. It has some very fine restaurants. And,
Oh, I know you'd love our Mardi Gras.
Well, I never tasted any, but I just bet it's delicious.
Yes. Shut my zipper.
Well, George, here's another guest of honor that came up from the audience.
Oh, well, this way, please. You talk right...
Do I talk right in here, mister?
Yeah, right there.
Well, now, if I do, you just tell me.
Yeah, that's the place.
Now, of course, you know, I've never spoken on radio before, and I'm awfully nervous.
I can see that, yeah.
As a matter of fact, I've never talked before an audience before.
Mm.
I never talk much, very much at home. I'm kind of a man of few words.
Yeah, a few thousand.
A few thousand. Now, mister.
Yes, sir, I was just coming to that, Mr. Burns.
Yes, yes.
Now, being New Orleans is a seaport and a river city, it has a great floating population. And it makes a lot of friends with its hospitality and has many fine restaurants. And you'll just love our Mardi Gras.
Wait a minute. The little lady here just told us all of that.
Yes, sir. That's where I learned it.
Well, our program is coming to an end, and I want to thank you people very much for coming up here tonight.
Well, if you really want to thank us, Mr. Burns, here's the way I figured out you can do it. When I get back to New Orleans, I'd like to have something to show that I've really been to Hollywood. Mm. And I thought maybe you and Miss Allen,
yes,
could give me something that I could take back home as a souvenir.
Well, mister, how would you like a nice live movie star?
A real live movie star?
Mm-hmm.
Well, if y'all ain't kidding me, the show would be make me very happy.
Well, it sure make me very happy, too.
Gracie, what live movie star are you going to give this man that'll make you both so happy?
Alice Faye.
Oh, Alice Faye, Henry, the movie star.
Takes me with a grain of salt. I never know where I stand. He never takes me seriously or even holds my hand. My sugar takes me with a grain of salt. He won't believe what I say. He's asking so mysteriously. He's got to far away. My love affair gets me nowhere. Why doesn't he realize I love him like seriously? Why doesn't he get wise? I try so hard to please my sugar, but it's an awful task. I ask him, won't you? Do you? Don't you? And every time I ask, my sugar takes me with a grain of salt. He treats me like I was dead. He plays around so scandalously, I feel like I will burst. My sugar takes me with a grain of salt. You think I was just fancy? He acts up to me personally, like there's a wall between. I've got no attitude, no attitude, just solitude. I wish he had a bit of my courtesy. Take me with a grain of salt. Why doesn't he realize I love you so magnanimously? Why doesn't he surprise?
Every year we hear a lot about Christmas fields, one of the finest causes for raising funds to help sick, needy people. But many of us don't think to do something about it until it's too late. This year, won't you do just this one thing? See that every Christmas letter and package you send carries a Christmas feast. The makers of those fine Campbell soups invite you to listen in and laugh with George Burns and Gracie Allen again next Wednesday. And meanwhile, remember that you can have the finest chicken soup you ever tasted simply by asking for Campbell's chicken soup. You'll find it to be the delicious, nourishing, old-fashioned kind.
Well, Gracie, say goodnight to everybody.
Oh, no, wait, Judge. I forgot to read in my proverb.
Proverb?
Mm-hmm.
You mean proverb?
Well, I know, but this is a proverb in verse. It's my proverb.
So it's a proverb.
Yes.
Well, let's hear it.
All right, proverb. Although it's very foolish, I've often heard it said, you can drive a horse to water, but a pencil must be lead.
Oh, you've made that up.
I didn't. So, girls, don't drive your husband to eat. Let nature take its course. Just give him Campbell's chicken soup, and he'll eat just like a horse. That's New Orleans.
Good night, all.
This is the Columbia Broadcasting. Your station is KHJ, Don Lee, Los Angeles. Time signal courtesy Schaefer Pen and Pencil Company. Settle that perplexing Christmas gift problem with a genuine Schaefer dry-proof fountain pen desk set. A gift that will delight anyone. There are over 100 Schaefer desk set designs, a style and price to fit every budget. Only $5 up. The tone indicates 1 minute and 15 seconds past 9.